In this video, we'll show you how to change the automatic rotor of your NH35 Seiko automatic movement. This can be useful if you want to swap to a custom rotor like this customized rotor we made here. First, take off the case back. If this is your first time, check out our guide on case back removal. With the case back removed, you should see a semicircular swinging weight. This is the rotor. The NH35 rotor is secured to the movement by this central screw. You'll need a screwdriver with the right width and thickness for a good grip. Firstly, it should be wide enough. Secondly, we need to be able to fully insert the screwdriver into the screw slot. Pro tip, you can further protect your screw by using a piece of stretch wrap. Forcing the issue with an unfit screwdriver can cause it to slip easily or even strip the screw. For the NH35 rotor, we'll need a tip that's larger than 2.5mm, but also thin enough to fit in the slot. If you're not sure on where to find one, we have a CNC machine screwdriver that's made specifically for the job. Before you start removing the rotor, quick tips on watchmaking safety. Remember not to touch the rotor or the movement with your bare fingers, as that'll leave a stain on the rotor. For that purpose, use only tweezers, Pegwood, or fingers with finger cuts when handling the movement. You should also avoid touching this area at all costs. This component consists of a balance wheel and a hairspring, which are extremely fragile and severely affects the accuracy of the movement if damaged. If you're not familiar with handling mechanical movements, I'd suggest you pause this video now and go through our guide on movement handling. Now, let's begin. Hold the watch by the case, and then insert the screwdriver into the screw slot. Maintain a firm downward pressure from the end of the screwdriver, and keep it perpendicular to the rotor. Then start turning the screw anti-clockwise, while focusing more on maintaining the downward pressure than turning the screw. Initially, the screw should be quite tight, so it is a good practice to slowly increase the turning force until it gets past the initial resistance point. From then on, the screw should be much easier to turn. Keep turning and unscrew the rotor. Once it's loose, remove the rotor and place it aside. Using a pair of tweezers, pick up the new custom rotor like this and place it onto the central post. First, we'll screw in the rotor lightly, a few turns will do. Then we'll check if the gears are engaging correctly by using Pegwood to rotate the rotor. If the gears are correctly engaged, you can proceed to tighten the screw. Remember, downward pressure and perpendicular to the rotor. Turn the screw until it stops. It is now snug tight. From this point onward, an extra 5 degrees of turn will sufficiently tighten the screw. Do not over tighten it or you'll risk damaging the screw thread. Now I'll clean the rotor with a hand pump and Rodico before closing the case back. We can then close the case back. Remember to tighten it for water resistance. You can make sure it's sealed tight by performing a water pressure test. It's a pretty technical test, so be sure to check out our guide on it before you do so. There you go. That's how you replace the rotor of your Seiko movement. Now you can enjoy your newly personalized watch. Thanks for watching. Remember to like and subscribe for more watchmaking tutorials and tips.